It might well be the apocalypse out there, but unfortunately for us, it's not zombie themed. These wannabe skeletons can't even seem to get the end of the world right. But today, I'm going to show you some tips and tricks that you can use to make these hungry walking corpses more entertaining for you and your player characters. What's up, guys? It's Evan here from D4 Dungeon. It's snowing outside and I'm stuck at home, so I'd like to welcome you all to another video. If this is your first time here and you want to learn how to level up your D&D experience, then start now by subscribing and hitting that bell below so that you don't miss a thing. Here's a brief physical description and general overview of a zombie. A zombie is a former creature, raised from death through necromancy to act as a minion without free will or personality. Like skeletons, a zombie can be made out of almost any solid creature, giving rise to much more variety than your standard humanoid. Unlike skeletons, however, these creatures retain some flesh on their bodies, and they move with a jerky, uneven gait. They're clad in the moldy apparel that they were put to rest in, and they carry the stench of decay and death. A zombie's only will is obedience to the orders of its controller. While not actively engaging in a threat, a zombie will just stand around, mindlessly staring at a wall. Their interpretation of orders is quite literal, and they lack independent problem-solving skills. A zombie will fight until destroyed, regardless of the amount or type of damage that it has sustained. There aren't many advantages to being a zombie, however, there are a few. Their undead fortitude ability means that if damage reduces a zombie to 0 hit points, it has to make a constitution saving throw of 5, plus the amount of damage taken, unless it's from radiant or a critical hit. And on a successful save, they drop to 1 hit point instead, preventing the zombie from being destroyed. They'll do this again and again and again, so it can almost make it seem like these things are impossible to kill. Zombies also have the undead nature feature, which means that they don't require air, food, drink, or sleep. Now, the disadvantages of a zombie seem fairly straightforward. They're hideous to look upon and they smell terrible. But what really brings these guys down is that they retain no vestige of their former selves. They like to approach targets by the most direct route possible, even if that means marching directly through an environmental hazard. They'll never pick up a dropped weapon unless directly commanded to do so. And they might break through a locked door, but they'd never think to unlatch it. The fact that there isn't much to combat and tactics for a zombie probably shouldn't come as a surprise. These D&D undead aren't really anything like the TV and movie zombies that we're all familiar with. They're not quick, they don't eat their victims, and they don't turn those bitten into new zombies. However, they will pursue their victim until that creature is either dead or they're ordered off by their controller. And their undead fortitude ability makes these things frighteningly relentless. One of the ways that I like to emphasize this in my game is by describing damage done to a zombie in such a way that your player characters think that there's no way they couldn't have just destroyed it. Having it fall prone, rolling it save, and then having it immediately get back up. To be honest, the fun from fighting a zombie isn't going to come from their tactical skill. It's going to come from the atmosphere and description that you can put into it as the DM. A zombie battle is just as likely to end in comedy as it is excitement. And as the DM, you should absolutely reward your players for coming up with unique and creative ideas in order to exploit the zombies' fundamental design flaws, like having them lead the zombies back through the dungeon they just explored so that they all fall into the pit trap that the party had skillfully navigated earlier in the adventure. The humanoid zombie and the ogre zombie in the Monster Manual fight in exactly the same way. The only real difference being that the ogre zombie has 4 times as many hit points and hits way harder. The beholder zombie from the Monster Manual will most likely use one of its eye ray attacks in combat, unless it has a player practically jumping into its mouth. The beholder is going to target a creature that it can see within 60 feet of it. You roll a d4 and consult the stat block to see what you can get. Each one of these eye beams can be devastating and turn the tide of battle. Depending on the randomness of your dice, you could disintegrate all of your players in as many rounds as there are characters. So, be careful. So to sum this video up, zombies are mindless automatons whose value is fairly limited. But given the right atmosphere And the impression that these creatures can't be killed will have your player characters backtracking out of whatever long-forgotten tomb it is that they took it upon themselves to plunder. I hope you guys were able to learn something about the Shuffling Undead today, and maybe about how to run an exciting encounter for both you and your player characters. Don't forget, if you want to learn more about DMing or other Dungeons & Dragons related stuff, then start now by hitting that subscribe icon so that you don't miss a thing. Thanks for watching the video, and I'll see you all next Monster Monday.